Cooking in the Kitchen at Olum's with registered dietitian Molly Morgan, Olum's cooking consultant.
Today we're making pomegranate martinis, which is fun.
Yeah, and we're going to make our own pomegranate syrup for them, which is really the key ingredient to all of this.
Yes.
So we're going to get started with 4 cups of pomegranate juice.
Okay.
And this makes a big batch of syrup, but if you're going to simmer it down the way you've got to make this, it's worth making a big batch because it also tastes great in seltzer.
Oh, perfect.
Yeah, so 4 cups.
Okay.
I've got a 1/2 cup of sugar there. And then we are going to put this over medium-high heat. We want it to come to a bubble and start to simmer. And then it cooks down for about 45 to 50 minutes.
Oh, wow.
So it gets nice and reduced.
Mm-hmm.
Got to add a little lemon juice to this,
sure.
too. So I have a little lemon juicer here.
I like that.
A little fun gadget.
Yeah.
And you can put the top on. And it's just about 1 tablespoon is all we need, which is roughly 1/2 of a lemon. And then it keeps all your seeds and stuff
in there, too.
Yeah. So add our lemon juice.
I like that.
Isn't that fun? You can find these in the produce section of the grocery store if you don't have one
Perfect.
For your home. Yeah.
And then the pomegranate, which this is the biggest pomegranate I've ever seen. I don't know about you at home, but
it
wow.
is a gigantic one. And they are worth the mess and worth the effort,
mm-hmm.
I think. So when you slice open a pomegranate, if you've not done it before, you slice them in half and
yeah.
you see this beautiful, colorful fruit. It's these little seeds is what we eat, or the areoles is what they're called. And you can just pop open a section and then you take them apart just
and
like that.
Yeah, these make me think, it kind of creeps me out a little bit when I'm taking these out. They just look like little eggs, like alien eggs. I know it's weird, but it's all right.
They're really good for you, alien eggs. Lots of antioxidants in these little guys.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to use this to garnish our martinis in a minute. If you want to bring our pitcher over.
Absolutely.
We can, this is one orange juiced. So it's fresh juices that are going in here. One lemon that's been juiced. It's about 2 tablespoons of lemon juice. 6 ounces of gin.
Yes, we're making alcoholic martinis today.
You could use vodka. So I had to sample the recipe, of course.
Yes.
We did make it with vodka and gin. And really, depending on your
preference.
But it would work with either, of course.
But I've also heard that if you like vodka, then you like gin, you just don't know it yet.
Ah, there you go. That's a good tip. Give us a little stir, just so our sugar dissolves in there. You can see how our syrup here has come to a bubble.
Mm-hmm.
So give it just another stir. You can turn down the heat, and then again, you're going to let it simmer a good 45 to 50 minutes. I'm going to bring on over our finished syrup, and you can see it reduces by almost half.
Yeah, wow.
So it gets really concentrated and sweet, because pomegranate juice is pretty tart if you've ever had just a glass of it.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to add 1/4 cup of pomegranate syrup to our martini. And if you want to give it a little stir.
Sure.
Now you can head this pitcher over to the refrigerator to chill it. I even served it over a little ice when I served it.
Okay.
Fill it
and also
glasses.
You can also do your glass, you can do some ice and water to chill your glass too beforehand.
Yeah, that's
a little bartender tip for you. I give you a little bit more, Molly.
Thank you.
There we go.
So this recipe that we made makes about 2 martinis. You could, of course, just whip up a bigger batch
for everybody for having like a fun little party.
And a couple of pomegranate seeds.
Nice.
They kind of float to the bottom.
Yes.
Cheers.
Yeah, cheers. Cheers.
For this pomegranate martini recipe, visit olums.com. Enjoy the day.
Cooking in the Kitchen was brought to you from the fully operational Thermidor Kitchen at Olum's.